So let's talk about changing initialization technique. So normally what we talked about is we initialize the weights randomly, right? But in more detail, what happens there is we initialize the weights randomly in a normal distribution. This technique does not work with the activation functions that we have. So that's why the people who have been doing research into deep learning or neural networks have been looking into how to come up with new initialization techniques and also how to make them work with activation functions. So, but let's first talk about the initialization technique. So the first one is the one that came out from the work of Glorot, specifically Glorot and Bengio. I don't know if I'm pronouncing this right, but it's called Glorot or Xavier initialization. So let's first talk about the distribution a little bit. This is a normal distribution. The mean could be different. In this one, the mean is zero, and that's also something that we want. And as you can see, the main characteristic is that the majority of numbers, specifically 68.2% of the numbers, are going to be between minus one times the standard deviation and plus one times the standard deviation. And as you go further away from it, it's going to be less and less. So for Glorot initialization, what they tell us is that we need to keep the mean at zero when we're initializing the weights. That is, if you remember, we initialize them randomly, but they're saying the mean should be zero and the standard deviation, well, in this case, the variance needs to be one divided by the average fan. So that is the number of inputs plus the number of neurons that we have. So it's the same as the number of outputs that we're going to give, divided by two. So it's basically the average number of these two. This specific initialization is best used with either linear or 10H or logistic or softmax activation functions. And this is actually the default initialization techniques in Keras. So if you want to use a different initialization technique, you have to change the initialization technique specifically in your code. But if you don't, if you want to use this one, you can just use a default version. You don't have to specify anything. The next one is Hey initialization, I guess how you would say it, not like H-E. Mean, again, needs to be zero, and the variance needs to be two divided by number of inputs. So as you can see, the difference is that with this one, I am dividing one by the average number of the number of inputs and the number of outputs. But here, what I do is I divide two by number of inputs. And this one is best used with ReLU or variance of ReLU. But we're going to talk about the variance of ReLU in a second. The last one is the lacun initialization. Again, I'm not sure if I'm saying it right. Mean needs to be zero and variance needs to be one divided by a number of inputs. This one is best used with ReLU, which is kind of a variant of ReLU, but we're going to learn about it in a sec. And here is a little useful table, but I will put this also in the course summary so you don't have to write it down or take a screenshot, so you can have access to all this information in the summary notes.